Hey, what's up, guys? Shit, my CYC motor is dead, and I killed it with 3,000 watts, not more than that. I was peaking at 3,000 watts, not even constant. The constant was at about 2,000. Anyways, I was at first skeptical when I've seen the 5 kilowatts rating on this motor, and I was like, no, there's no way this thing can do that because it's just too small. I've been working with motors for a while now. I kind of know their sizes and what they're capable of. But I thought maybe this was some high quality small motor that might reach those peaks. And some people on Facebook told me that they did reach these numbers, and probably they were working at the cold ambient temperature, and these 5 kilowatts rating probably were short bursts and like not continuous. Anyway, I was riding at night a few days ago. It's pretty chilly outside, probably about 18 degrees Celsius. I was going at about 60 kilometers per hour for about 10 to 15 minutes. And all of a sudden, I lost all the power. I wasn't sure why, because it never happened to me before. No wiring issues whatsoever. Controller was fine. No errors on the controller. So I tried to do the auto recognition of the motor again through my nuclear menu, and I've seen the cog moving just slightly, but hasn't enough power to move the cogs, like to do the complete rotation or to move my wheels. So I realized something was wrong with my motor. After I pedaled back home and did a short investigation, I realized my rotor is dead, and it's not the windings, it's not the electrical part, it's the rotor, the thing in the middle that spins this thing. Look how easy I just pulled it out. Usually you need to apply a decent force to pull it out because of the magnetic force, but it just lost it completely, just a piece of metal now. So yeah, this thing overheated and lost its magnetic field. The thing is, it's very hard to cool it. I was thinking, all right, ferrofluid maybe, but then again, I will be transferring heat from the rotor to my stator. It's two hot pieces. It's not the best idea. It will probably reduce the heat of the rotor just a bit, but this is not a good solution. Anyway, I was like, wait a second. Well, I don't want to reduce my power output, because I think 3000 watts is like the sweet spot between my mechanical life of the parts on my bike, like my drivetrain. I can handle pretty well these 3000 watts without breaking on me every now and then. And also that it would be just disappointing to go to for lower rating, because you're getting used to the power, and I didn't want to go any lower than that. So my solution was putting air through the whole motor. I was like, wait, why not blow air through the damn motor and cool the whole thing all together? Some of you told me this won't work. I'm not sure why. I'm pretty sure this will work pretty good, because what could go wrong? I mean, besides the dust and dirt, which I will also find a way to protect from, I will probably use a filter, and I will probably keep on designing this. This is just the first test that I did in about 2 hours of designing and printing altogether. But I will probably design another duct that will cover the fan. This is not the actual fan. The actual fan will be much bigger and faster. I will print some cover on it that will make harder for the dust and maybe even water to get through. Probably something that will go all over the motor and down with a filter on the bottom of it. So yeah, I don't think I'm gonna have dust issues. Maybe I will need to service my motor more frequent than without the air cooling, but this thing is definitely gonna worth it. Anyway, so this is, just a second, let me separate the rotor. This thing's bolts in, you see, four bolts. I removed the glass for the air to go through. This just bolts on to the cap, and then the cap goes onto the motor. So it just blows cold air from the outside into the motor, cools the stator and the rotor together. And then I have this gear plate that would be here. And I will probably drill some holes in it for the air to be exhausted, for the hot air from the motor to be exhausted outside. I'm not sure if it's gonna be a single hole or maybe a few small ones all around it. I'm not sure, but I will figure it out later. And that's basically it. I mean, why wouldn't it work? I think it's a great idea. I'm not sure about it. Yeah, but I'm pretty confident it's gonna work in a good way, and I'm pretty confident it's gonna reduce my temperatures drastically. But anyway, so yeah, this is the first test. A few of them are about to be printed to make sure the sizes are fine to make the best airways in it. And yeah, wish me luck, guys. I will definitely update you once it will be installed, and I will be monitoring temperatures with it and without it. So stay tuned. I will update you about this in the next video. Bye-bye.